Hi, I'm on page 14 and 15 in the All-in-One Approach, Book 1A. On page 14 is Cuckoo Crazy by Ed McLean. So this piece, my goodness, students love this little piece. It's in 3/4 time. The tempo says lively. And guess what? There's a lot of reinforcement of two-note slurs in the left hand. So students will understand that nice dropping and rolling motion. There are practice steps that go along with that piece, as you can read, and the duet part just sounds like a little cuckoo bird. And then. And then. And then at the end. Maybe that's why the students like it so much. They like to hear that cuckoo bird in your part. And the musicality girl asked, did you hear a legato sound? So I play that piece pretty lively. So many of our students will not be able to play it that quickly. And that's all right. We tell them to play at a thinking tempo so they can really think about that legato connection. And also their drops and their rolls. So the phrasing is just perfect when they use the drop and the roll motion. The next page on page 15 is a theory page. What is the difference between slurs and ties? Right, so in the orange box, it does explain the difference between the two musical symbols. And then there's a whole bunch of little notes here where students can write in whether it's a tie or a slur. So the very first two notes is a slur, right? And then a tie note is the second one, because right? It's the same note with a little slur under it. So in the second part of this page, students have to draw a slur over the notes and then a slur under the notes for the second activity. And then we ask them to play those two exercises and listen for legato sound. So you notice that I'm always asking students to think, to listen, to be musical beings.